In a rush. We bring out the word of God.
That's right.
What's your name? Say it again. Keywon. All right, nice to meet you, Keywon. Do you know who you are according to the Bible? Your nationality, your nationhood, your nation of origin. What do you stand for? Let's let this ambulance come back. And I want you, brother, like I told the last brother, whenever men are talking, men speak as men. We don't speak as effeminate, docile little boys. That's the idea of the Christian church. They want you to talk like that. Right? So I want you to speak up. Put a little bass in your voice. Go ahead.
What's your name? Keywon? All right. Now, what's your nation? What nation are you from? I want you to look at this sound right here. Check that sound out.
Everybody over here under the sound of my voice, come check the sound out. Whatever your father is, that's what you are. All right? Give me that numbers one. So right here, the blacks, so-called blacks, that's what you are, that's what your father is? Judah, you from Judah?
That's right.
All right, listen at this.
This is the book of Numbers, chapter 1 and verse 18. And they assembled all the congregation together on the first day of the second month. And they declared their pedigree.
Their pedigrees is their lineage, brother. You hear me? My brother. It's your lineage. Lineage, right? Where you stem from, right? Read.
And they assembled all the congregation together on the first day of the second month. And they declared their pedigrees after their families by the house of their fathers.
So whatever your father is, that's what you are. Because the man carries the seed.
Right.
Right, the woman, she incubates that seed for a period of time, then that seed comes out. It's like if I take an apple seed and plant it on the west side, or if I plant it on the south side, it's gonna come up whatever it is that I planted.
Right.
An apple tree, right? So come over here and talk to me, my brother. We're talking about building up our nation. And it starts with the man.
That's right.
If the man can't get himself together, the woman will not follow.
That's
right. What a woman look like following a clueless dude? She gonna keep him to the side as he's convenient. We have to learn to be men. Give me 1 Kings 2 and 2. We're gonna show you according to the Bible how to be a man. Now we might have thought that coming up in this society, we learn how to be men. No, we learn how to be boys.
That's right.
We learn how to be Esau's or the so-called white man's boys. That's why he called us a boy when he had us captive. Read.
The book of 1 Kings. Chapter 2 and verse 2. I go the way of all the earth. Be thou strong, therefore, and show thyself a man.
Show thyself a man. This is King David, our mightiest king, right? He was talking to his son. King David was on his deathbed. He was giving him the game. He telling him, this is how you be a man. This is what I want you to do. After I'm gone, I want you to be a man. And how does he say you to be a man? Read.
And keep the charge of the Lord thy God, to walk in his ways, to keep his statutes and his commandments.
You hear that? To keep the commandments. That's how we be a man.
That's right.
We have to, is this your girlfriend? Yeah. That's up to him. So it's unestablished. So y'all just friends with benefits? Well, like what is it?
Bring it out.
Are y'all together?
Yeah.
My brother, you're amongst men, okay? We're going to teach you according to thus said the Lord how to be men, right? So, the Bible says in order to be a man, you got to keep the commandments. One of the commandments is that we do not create baby mamas. One of the commandments is that we love our sisters and marry one wife.
That's right.
Marry our wives. That woman will follow you to the end if you treat her as a man supposed to treat a woman.
That's right.
And not some jump off piece.
Yeah.
Not a condom. Not a living live condom. You treat her as a woman and you make her your woman.
Yes,
right?
Sir.
Read.
Hebrews.
Yes, sir.
The book of Hebrews, chapter 13 and verse 4.
Yeah.
Marriage is honorable.
Now, what's y'all status?
Marriage is honorable.
You hear that, my brother? My sister, you hear that? Marriage, little sister, that's your little sister? Your daughter, you hear that? Marriage is honorable. So when it's time for you to actually prove somebody, you can't just jump in the bed with them. You gotta go through a process of proving, because whoever it is you jump in the bed with, that's supposed to be the person that's yours forever.
That's right.
You are special. You are royalty. You are a jewel. Yeah. You can't just give that to anybody.
Right.
They have to earn that.
That's right.
Don't lower yourself to a standard that was set forth by this society.
Right.
This society said that you are a dime a dozen. No, you are one of one. And for a man to be a part of you, guess what? You have to prove him.
Good.
Continue with the godly man after this.
Okay. Marriage is honorable in all, and the bed undefiled.
You hear that? The bed is undefiled. That means whatever you and your wife want to do, that's up to y'all. But ain't no crossing the lines either. Don't have a digging all in you. You treat her like a woman, treat him like a man, right? Read.
But whoremongers.
Now here's the spin. Anything outside of marriage is what?
Whoremongers.
You hear that? That's whoremongering. She's still on the market. You still on the market. Y'all ain't together. Y'all still on the market, free to do anything. The Lord called that whormongering. You sleeping around from man to man, a woman to woman. That's whoremongering. But God, think about that, Reed.
And adulterers.
If y'all actually did end up getting married, and then you slept outside of your marriage, what God say?
God will judge.
God will judge. How does God judge adulterers? My brother, Bernie, that's one way. What's another way? Because you could, if you an adulterer, and you're laying up in somebody else's house, that husband or that wife can come home, bring out a knife, bring out a gun, kill you dead. That's judgment from God.
Right.
You could be trying to get away from that situation when that husband come home and jump out the window and break your damn neck trying to get away.
Right.
God will judge. What's another way God will judge? Give me that Deuteronomy. Absolutely. Child support. That's a judgment of adultery. You done messed around with this woman and got her pregnant, and guess what? She got all your information. She's taking you to child support court. You tried to do this thing on the sneak, but God brought it to the open. He can also plague you or judge you with diseases. You understand that? An adulterer will be subject to diseases. If I'm sleeping with my wife and we monogamous and we ain't never ever going outside our relationship, what worry do we have of catching a disease?
Bring it out.
We ain't got no worry. But if you in a relationship where y'all not committed, where y'all not bound by God, guess what? You're susceptible to those diseases. Gonorrhea, herpes, AIDS, everything, right? That's a judgment of God. Read.
The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 28, verse 61.
Yeah.
Also, every sickness and every plague, which is not written in the book of this law, them will the Lord bring upon thee.
You hear that? Everything is not written. AIDS not written in this book.
Right.
Gonorrhea is not written in this book.
Bring it out.
Herpes not written in this book. He said, all those will I bring upon thee. If you break my commandments. You understand, as a nation, as a group of people, we steady break God's commandments. Before you came out, we were showing how we got in slavery. Look at this. Come check this sign out. Please come check this sign out. Look at this. This is the so-called blacks' treatment here in America. This is the so-called blacks' treatment over in Arabia and all over the world. This happened to our people. These are our people too, the Native American Indians and the Hispanics. Those are our people. We experience the same thing. Why? Because we committed sin.
That's right.
None of this is ever gonna change. Do you understand? Slavery is still going on today. In Arabia, they selling you and they selling me, people that look like us, $200, $400. It's still going on.
Bring it out.
Why? Because we have not come back to the laws of our God.
Right.
Read.
Also, every sickness and every plague which is not written in the book of this law, them will the Lord bring upon thee until thou be destroyed.
You hear that? Why she wearing a mask today? Why they advise us to wear a mask? What God just say? Every plague, every sickness, he will bring upon thee. Don't get a white man no credit. Don't get a Chinese man no credit. The Lord put a spirit on them to create these different things. The Lord said, I kill, I make alive.
That's right.
Deuteronomy 32 and 39. The Lord is responsible for all this. Don't give the devil no credit. Everybody works for the Lord to do what? To make sure you and me stand up right as rulers of this earth. That's our destiny in this place.
Out.
But if we don't want to rule this place, guess what? We're going to get kicked to the side. This is ours. You can read about that in 2nd Ezra.
The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 32 and verse 39. See now that I, even I, am he, and there is no God with me. I kill.
I what?
I kill.
God says I kill.
And I make alive.
And I make alive. Read.
I wound.
I wound. Those bullet wounds that our brothers and sisters get, the Lord said, I'm responsible for it.
Bring it out.
Nobody else get credit for that. Your white God, your so-called white false idol, he don't get credit for that.
That's right.
The thug on the block, he don't get credit for that.
That's right.
The Lord said, I wound.
And I heal.
And I heal. If you got the worst situation ever, and you think ain't no way around it, the Lord said, I heal. He does these things. Not modern medicine, not modern science. God said, I heal. Read.
Neither is there any that can deliver out of my hand.
When God got you on his radar, Lord have mercy.
Used to scream black power while Heron was pushed. But at the end of the day, nothing's in vain. IUIC has been given a vision. The tents of Judah has risen. Many has attempted the mission, minor murmuring, omitting, and missing the mark. Just reading that he had the flame of fire in his eyes gave us the spark. We on Paul's mission. We out on the road, purple and gold. From Mexico, Cuba, Haiti, Ghana, Sierra Leone. 144,000 boots banging, concrete crackling. These are how our men repented at heart. The scriptures is proof. IUIC, we deliver the truth.